his own special dream, and your dream's just about to come true. Life's not as bad as it may seem if you open your eyes to what's in front of you. Real dreamers, toys will make you happy.
Ladies and gentlemen, Lauren, Marcella, and Tori performing Dream Girls for the Broadway play. Now we will bring those ladies. I'm going to find out if it's... How would you have to be called this morning? Guys or gals? Either or. Okay, grab a microphone and sit down. I'm in kind of a loss here this morning, to tell you the truth. All right, let's get to introduce everybody. We didn't meet Rondretta yet. Rondretta, you are a chef by trade. Is that right? You got to hold this nice and close.
That's correct.
Okay, and next to me, next to Rondretta, is Tori. Tori, you're a hairdresser?
Yes, I am.
Okay, and next to Tori is Lauren. Lauren, you're also a hairdresser. No, you're a florist. And over on the end is Marcella, and you are a hairdresser also. Yeah. We've got to get a microphone. We're getting one up to you as we speak. Let's ask you this. How are you, first off, accepted in what is commonly referred to as a very conservative community, which is Rochester, New York?
Well, with putting on the hits on television now, it's pretty well accepted, and since people find that it's going on in their own city, they're very curious, and they come out, and they're very, very curious about it.
Tori, you do this, obviously, you three or four that are here do this kind of more or less as a, entertainment end of it. You did something over at RIT just a little while ago. Tell us what that was all about.
We just did a benefit production at RIT to raise money for Camp Good Days and Special Times, and it was very successful. Let me see.
It was a stage presentation that took place.
It was.
Okay, how many
in the tradition of a Broadway show?
It was a Broadway show. Mm-hmm. Okay, Lauren, is there any other outlets for your type of performance, your type of stage entertainment, other than something like that? Is there any other place in Rochester that you can do this?
Not really. What we're trying to do is develop something so we can take it elsewhere, get more into productions, more into a Broadway type show, right here in Rochester, which the following is increasing more and more as more shows we do.
Mm-hmm. Marcella, you were, I remember you down at the lip sync contest at the festival tent. I was a judge that night. I remember you down there. I see three people here that weren't there that night. There were about four or five others. How many of there are you in the city that you would know?
A lot.
A lot?
Yes. The city's filled. for a conservative city.
You got to admit, though, folks, right? If you don't, some of these guys look a lot better than some of the ladies that you run across. And,
huh? We work at it. We work at it.
You know, that brings up, now that brings up an interesting point. Do you ever get together collectively as a group and decide to go out someplace at night just to have fun?
Go out drinking.
Yes. Go out drinking. Yeah. See if you get hit on
it. It's fun. It's real fun.
Have you ever done that?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, come on. Talk to us about this here. Let's hear a little bit about this.
Well, it's. Some people may look at it as unfair, but we go out to promote the harmony and goodwill to all men and women.
And wait a minute. Why am I getting a laugh over here, Lauren? That didn't sound like you believed a word he said.
Oh, I do believe. I do believe.
Yeah.
You believe.
I do believe.
You're right. We do go out to make happiness all over this beautiful county of Monroe. Some good, some bad. Some women don't care to ever see our faces again on the sidewalks, but hey, you know, life goes on.
Now, to put something together like this and the outfits and so on and so forth, Corporal Klinger, first off, would fall in love with you guys because he'd want your your wardrobe here. How long does it take you to prepare to get to look like you do? A half hour, 15 minutes?
No, she's crazy, too.
Ladies, maybe we can all learn something this morning.
We were up this morning at 5 o'clock. Starting to get ready.
And I was up at 7.
We didn't start till 7.
Yes,
we
didn't indeedy, start. She was.
We really didn't start till 7 o'clock
right.
This morning. She woke me up first thing in the morning. I said, who is this? I was ready to hang out.
He, she. Now, how do I address you? Do I say guys, gals? Or do
well,
I
whatever
say
you
one
want to call us.
We don't care.
You don't care. How's it? We'll just make it generic.
No,
it.
Well,
it. Long hair down.
I mean, come on.
We're it.
We share.
Really?
We refer to each other as... she, because we're around each other, and once we get into character, we try and portray and feel the whole role. So we'll call each other she from now on then, but it's just because we know each other. But when we're in a like at RIT, we do try to keep our gender straight and let them know that we are still men performing.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, we may camp it up here and there, but we are men. Let's not forget that.
Okay, we won't. We'll be back to talk to more of you, as a matter of all of you again. Another performance coming up from Lauren this morning, but first let's take a commercial break. Got to pay my high salary, guys. We'll be right back here live at Marketplace. Don't go away.
Visit the Marketplace, the mall that adds enjoyment to your shopping. Freshen up your wardrobe with the latest in fashion-right apparel made available in Sibley's, McCurdy's, Sears, JCPenney, and the many stores, shops, and services along the way. Whether your needs are your own or for that extra special person, give yourself a treat and enjoy shopping the Marketplace.
All roads lead to Marketplace Mall.
My name is John Darcy, and I own an antique business in Rochester called Adventures in the Past. We are constantly looking for items to fill our 12 display rooms at 2 locations. Here's some examples of items that you might have and what we would be willing to pay for them. $600 for this dresser, $300 for old toys like these, and $1,000 for this oriental rug. Here's your chance to raise money. Call us now while we're eager to buy. We're a reputable company. Call Adventures in the Past at 262-4776.
Harold's is the place for back-to-school buys, and choice is the word to remember. For Wrangler, Harold's has 100% cotton denim jeans and colorful Wrangler cords. Buy any 3 Wrangler jeans or pants and get a pair free with proof of purchase from Wrangler. Wrangler pre-washed denim jeans are on sale through Saturday at Harold's, your choice for back-to-school.
And we are back live at Marketplace Mall. We're talking to 4 female impersonators here from Rochester this morning. Why do you do this, Rondretta? Why do you dress up like this? What's the purpose behind it?
We all have different reasons. My reason is I was theater fanatic in high school. promote myself. I was written up in high school students for Who's Who of America.
Hold it, darling. You've got some lipstick on your teeth here. Okay,
how
fine,
observant.
Go ahead.
We're going to make him up before the show's over.
Yes.
No.
A quick transformation.
No.
Tom George, you look great. I got a wig backstage.
Yeah,
in an extra dress.
I like theater, and since we tend to laugh at ourselves at humorous things and don't take things too seriously if they're too serious, I chose female impersonation so I could have a bit of both.
Good for you. Tori, do you get paid for these things?
Yes.
Do you actually make money on it, yeah?
Yes, we do.
Yes, like good money, bad money?
Well,
do you perform outside of town, Rochester, Toronto? I mean, New York, Toronto,
it
anywhere like that?
It keeps me in peroxide.
It keeps you... Is that your real hair?
No,
it isn't. But, you know, Rondretta, I got to say to you, when you were walking in this morning, I was watching you walk in the parking lot. This stuff was flowing behind you. But now that I get closer, I see that you've got it pinned out. It looks like it's your real.
That's the whole illusion. If these lights were darker, you'd swear it was all mine, but it's not.
It's not. Is that yours?
Yep.
That is your real hair.
That's mine.
Ain't it awful. What was that?
Ain't it awful. All right.
What about that?
That's real, too.
No, it's not.
It's
Don't
real.
Believe her.
Okay, we've got a picture here. Tori, this was, tell us about this pageant. This is the one that you won, and this is you sitting here getting crowned. Tell us a little bit about this.
Every year, the community puts together a big pageant involving all of the female impersonators in Rochester. And it's based on poise, beauty, talent, glitter. And I like the glitter.
How many entered?
I think 15. 16.
Okay. 16.
And I was contestant number 14, and I won.
What did you win for that? There's a lot of money involved? Or?
I did a production that I took from Funny Girl, where I came out and I did I'm the Greatest Star, dressed as the Carol Burnett character with the slouchy costume and the whole thing. Mm-hmm. And towards the end of the number, where I exit off the stage, I make a fast change where this dress that I have on right now is underneath, and I come out finishing the song doing I'm the Greatest Star.
Marcella, you sent us a postcard, which is kind of unique. I don't know if I have one here or if you do, but tell us about that. That's something that, are you marketing yourself, so to speak?
Yeah, well, I've been working on this idea for a long time, and thanks to Jim Gayhart, my photographer, we finally selected one, and it took us about a year and a half to get it together, and now it's selling to several stores in the city.
For those who are not familiar, and because I just saw it, and I'm sure a lot of people here haven't, kind of describe what it looks like. It's a picture of you on the front.
Yes. No, everybody... Yeah.
It's a picture of you, I think, with a boa or something around you, and...
There's a lot of balloons around me.
Yeah.
It looks like I'm in a big bubble bath.
Yeah. And on the back side just says your name, address, and where you're going to hold your case.
Right.
Okay. Do you have an agent, any of you fellows?
No, we're looking.
Lauren, you're the
She's
agent, are you?
She is.
Okay. Now, I understand, Lauren, if you'll get set up for a second here, we're going to have you do a number for us, and maybe I'll have Rondretta help me exactly what this is all about. This is Greatest Love by Whitney Houston.
Greatest Love by Whitney Houston. What it is this is a number taken from our benefit show, and we did a slide presentation of the kids at summer camp. And this is a song about finding the greatest love within yourself.
All right, so if you will, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Lauren doing Greatest Love by Whitney Houston.
them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside. Give them a sense of pride to make it easier. Let that children's laughter remind us how we used to be.
It's Bosley's Law. She who buys bargain trash bags can be penny wise, but trash foolish.
Oh, I almost made it. So close.
Close doesn't count in trash bags, Judy. Why take chances? Flat trash bags are...